My name is Takanori Yoko. I am student of Nagoya University, Japan. I'd like to introduce background of my work. In our laboratory, we can conduct research on free viewpoint television. The virtual view from virtual camera is generated by the images from real cameras. User can select the location of virtual camera. They can enjoy images from arbitrary viewpoints. This is a virtual view. This is a video captured by merge camera. As you can see, the viewpoints are changed sparsely. In contrast with this video, the viewpoints are changed very smoothly in this right video. This video is free viewpoint video. We can change viewpoints back and forward. This is a flowchart of conventional free viewpoint image generation. I will explain you each step briefly. First, we capture the scene and conduct pixel value to between two images in order to depth map. And we shift the images between two, we shift the images based on calculated depth map. This is called as warping. Finally, we generate a new image, both two warped images. So far, we use fixed camera array to capture images for free viewpoint image generation. This picture shows 100 eye camera systems in Nagoya University. It includes 100 cameras. The gap between two cameras is 5 centimeters, and capturing range is only up to 5 meters. The conventional method using fixed camera array needs a lot of setting and computational cost. For example of computational cost, the number of camera is increased. So, calculating costs for calibration and depth estimation is also increased. For example of setting cost, many cameras are required, and high accuracy adjustment of optic axis is also required. If we try to achieve a free viewpoint image generation in wide space with small number of camera, the gap between two camera is widened as a result. It is difficult to estimate the depth map in high accuracy. So, the quality of generated image is not good. Therefore, we propose moving camera array and generate the free viewpoint image of moving camera. When the moving camera array captures the images, the graph shows between position and time. We compare the graph of fixed camera array and moving camera array. As you can see, we can take images from one camera position with proposed moving camera array. For this, with this advantage, we propose a higher quality image generation. This is a flowchart of proposed method. I describe each step. First, the images are captured by moving camera array, then generated depth map. This is an example image from moving camera. And this depth map is generated by this image. In conventional method, the virtual view of this point is generated only using left and right images. Two best use of dense acquisition of the array, we use for generating with not only spatial domain, but also temporal domain. In proposed method, we use four images, left and right images, and the images with neighboring frame and cross generating position. First, the virtual view of this middle point is generated following conventional method. Then, the virtual view of this point is generated using this upper image. And the virtual view of this point is generated using this lower image. After that, the final virtual view of this middle point is generated using these three images. In these three images, the position of static object is similar, but the position of moving object is different. For this reason, it is necessary to separate the static object and moving object. The separation is conducted by comparing the pixel value these two images and creating mask image. Based on the mask image, the moving object is only using this virtual image, and the static object is selected by these two images. Experiment is conducted to evaluate our proposed method using stop motion animation. Experimental procedure is as follows. Step one. The camera was moved 50 centimeters on X direction. Images were captured when cameras passed each 1 centimeter. Step two. Then the object was moved, and step one was conducted. Step 3. Step 1 and step 2 were repeated 10 times. This image sequence is equal to 10 frame image sequence taken by 50 cameras. Step 4. By selecting the several camera position and frames, we create image sequence from shoot moving camera. The shoot movement is shown using red dots. Experimental environment is like this. And the table shows devices for experiment. This is images captured by a fixed camera. And this is images captured by a shoot moving camera. We use images from four cameras. In conventional method, we use camera A and B for image generation. In conventional method, camera A, B, C, and D is used for image generation. We compare this proposal with conventional method by evaluating the image quality using PSNR. This is experimental result of this example. About 2.4 dB is increased. Let me enlarge these areas to show you the difference more clearly. In conventional method, these edges are not well generated. But in proposed method, these edges are well generated. Conclusion. We propose a moving camera array as an alternative camera system. This system is suitable for capturing a wide space. For this camera configuration, we further propose a novel view synthesis method. In this method, we use the viewpoints in both spatial and temporal directions. For future work, we are planning to use motion vector for separating static object and moving objects. That's all. Thank you.
So, once more, some interesting results for view synthesis. Do you have any questions? I guess I had a quick one about the practicality of a moving camera system. How easy is it to build a moving camera system compared to a fixed camera? If you were to build a camera you wanted to walk around with. If you wanted to build a camera to hold and to walk around with multiple views and moving camera. Do you think you could do that?
Uh, Sorry.
Too hard question. Okay, that's fine. Okay, where's our next speaker? Thanks, Steve.